Enter Kendall Pease, P-E-A-S-E. I'm the Public Affairs Officer for the On-Site Inspection Agency.
Super. Can you tell me, sir, a little bit about what went on here today?
What we've just seen is the first elimination of ground launch cruise missiles here in the United States under the INF Treaty. There will be 41 missiles eliminated here this period for a total of 443 missiles, total missiles being eliminated under this treaty in the next 3 years.
And what is happening concurrent in the Soviet Union? Same thing.
The Soviet Union is at this time eliminating their missiles. To date, they've eliminated over 277 missiles. Of course, they have a larger inventory. They have approximately 1,846 missiles to eliminate. The United States has 846 to eliminate under the treaty.
Is there an exact time period when this is scheduled to be finished?
This has to be all done within 3 years of the enter into force of the treaty, which the three-year period is up in June 1991.
We expect everything to be finished by then?
We expect everything to be done. It's going well. The first 3 months of this treaty, it's a 13-year regime, but we're very happy. First blush, it looks wonderful.
This is an historic occasion.
Well, I'm glad to be part of it. I think you're right, it is historic. It's perhaps the first real tangible evidence that maybe we'll have peace on Earth.
Well, I mentioned in my speech that today was the last of the first in implementing this INF Treaty. The treaty's been in force for 3 months now. We have inventoried the total systems belonging to each other's side that pertain to the treaty, and we have actually started the eliminations. And today is the last of the first systems to begin to be eliminated. We eliminated the first ground launch cruise missile.
Is there a deadline when the missile has to be eliminated by?
Yes, the treaty specifies that within 3 years, all of the systems covered by the treaty have to be eliminated. But the treaty itself extends for another 13 years, allowing each side's inspectors to visit former installations to verify that there is no INF-related activity.
Do you think that what's happening now points to a roadmap?
I think we have to be practical about what's going on here. It's a small step, a step in a positive direction. The United States and the Soviet Union have decided to cap this class of weapons, that is those with a range between 500 and 5,000 kilometers. And let's not take it any further than that. If it becomes in our interest to eliminate strategic systems or to reduce strategic systems, then we'll take that when it comes along. And hopefully, with the confidence that we've achieved in implementing the INF Treaty, we will have more confidence in our ability to verify a strategic treaty.
If tomorrow all the things were gone I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Today, 'cause there ain't no doubt.